My dear friends, today after a long time, I am uploading this video in YouTube for the beginners. I am trying to show the phacoemulsification surgery of grade 4 nuclear sclerosis patient. After making both sides side port, instill the 0.6% trypan blue dye and after 10 seconds, remove the dye. Now, inject 2% HPMC. Spread some HPMC over the corneal surface so as to enhance the visualization. Now, by using bent tip cystitome of 26 gauge needle, I am starting the rexis and trying to make a continuous curvilinear capsular rexis of adequate size. This is totally unedited video. See how much time I am taking to make this rexis. Now this rexis is completed. Inject some 2% HPMC. And then make a triplanar main port by using 2.8 steel keratome. This is main port. Now, after making the main port, I am doing the hydro procedures. First, hydrotisection. And then hydrodelineation. In very hard cataract, don't try for the delineation. Make hydrotisection in multiple points of the rexis margin. Now inject some HPMC and then rotate the nucleus. This free rotation of the nucleus indicate there is no any corticocapsular additions. Now again inject some HPMC and then start the phacoemulsification surgery. At this time inject the phaco probe from the main port and from the left-sided side port, insert the chopper. In this technique, I will show you modified direct chop technique, in which first I emulsify some superficial cortex and then make a small trench in US1 mode. After making the adequate size trench, now go to the US2 mode. Rotate the nucleus about 45 degree and embed the phaco tip. Hold the nucleus एंड देन चॉप इट इन टू हेमी न्यूक्लियाई. नाउ रोटेट द न्यूक्लियस, अगेन एम्बेड द फेकोटिप, होल्ड द न्यूक्लियस एंड चॉप इट. ट्राई टू मेक मल्टीपल चॉप्स एज मच एज पॉसिबल. After chopping, now hold the one piece of the nucleus, bring it from periphery to the center, and then emulsify it. At this time, Fico power is 60, flow rate is 40, and vacuum is 200. I am bringing the nuclear pieces from periphery to the center and then emulsifying it. Always remember, use the FECO energy at right time. Don't waste the FECO energy inside the AC. Almost all pieces of the nucleus have been emulsified. This is last nuclear piece. See what precautions I am taking at this moment. I am removing this chopper so as to prevent this chatter particle penetration into the posterior capsule. Now remove some epinucleus or cortex with the help of either synco cannula or coaxial or bimanual cannula. I usually use synco cannula, synco irrigation aspiration cannula. It is very safe instrument for this purpose. At this time, I am separating the cortex from the capsular bag and bringing it into the center. Now aspirate this cortical matter thoroughly. Always remember, while doing this maneuver, don't face the aspiration tip towards the posterior capsule. Always keep it up or towards the optics while removing this cortex. To the hydropolis in such a way that any cortical fibers should not be here inside the posterior capsular surface. Now inject 2% HPMC and load the intraocular lens inside the cartridge. At this time, I am loading the hydrophilic aspheric intraocular lens inside the cartridge. See how I am loading hydrophilic aspheric intraocular lens . Now I am implanting this intraocular lens . Implant the intraocular lens in such a way that the leading haptics should go into the bag, and then dial the trailing haptics with the help of lens dialer. Now the lens is in the bag. After implanting the intraocular lens, remove the entire HPMC from the anterior chamber. Don't leave any part of the HPMC inside the AC or at the back of the lens. I always remove completely the HPMC. Otherwise, it may create wrist intraocular tension postoperatively. You can do this manner with the help of bimanual irrigation aspiration cannula. Now, after removing the HPMC, inject 0.1 ml pilocarpine intracamerally, and then inject preservative free moxifloxacin inside the AC and wash it thoroughly. Thank you very much for watching this video.